What's... this thing. I see plenty of ruins around here, too. It must have been a big town bustling with people back in the day.
For Crown Contest participants, places such as these are but vectors for the astral energy they pursue. Similar to that windmill, for instance.
I never miss!
Here I come! Catapult! It's on!
Steel
force!
Ignite!
Air thrust!
Dragon form!
Here it goes!
I'm ready!
One more! This ends now!
Consider yourself finished!
A comfortable win.
One of Hoodle's friends.
Stronger.
Do you think this is one of the places where the Dark Wings and Almeidrea fought?
I wouldn't be so sure. This place appears more ravaged by time than combat. Even if there are signs of destruction, it would likely have taken place during the Great Conquest of 300 years prior.
And ever since, it's been a breeding ground for Zoogles, I guess.
ship!
Glacial
Try
spear
it for me!
In here!
Crush! Air pressure! Try
Do it!
For me!
This ends now!
Consider yourself finished!
Let's keep our eyes on the prize.
Retreat if you know what's good for you.
This one's mine.
Bloody hot! No further!
Now!
Can you take in an instant?
Impact Cross!
Small, but a victory nonetheless.
We have a long way yet to go.
Retreat if you know what's good for you.
Here it
is.
Not in your dream. I'm only getting started.
Elusive deity.
Let
me
defend. Hear my thunder.
Here I come.
Down on the ground.
Try harder.
Going.
Where are you going?
Armor won't save you.
Ruin gate.
Here.
This one keeps
Radiant
charging us.
Do it. That's what my shield is for.
Astral energy.
Say no more. Now, take this.
Shine.
Radiant Light!
Dragon Form!
I'll heal you all!
Its armor's too strong!
Healing Force!
Split it open!
Hey,
be my guest!
Heal Force!
Annihilating! Try harder! Not
again! Hey,
Dragon Form!
Burning Strike!
Glacial Spear!
Here's evil!
Dragon Form!
Freeze Lancer!
Our work is done here. Let's move.
I'm right behind you, Shion.
What do you say we check back in on the ranch?
I hope we manage to catch Almeidrea soon.
I hope so too, before she can cause any more havoc.
You okay, Rinwell?
Oh, yeah.
Don't push yourself too hard now, okay?
Okay. Thanks. Oh, Hoodle. I don't know what to do. Easy peasy. I knew I could handle it. Mmm, this ice cream tastes so good.
I swear, you're always having ice cream, even when it's freezing cold out.
And who made you the food police?
No one. I'm just saying that's a lot of ice cream. Don't you ever, you know, throw up or anything?
Did you really just say that? Try thinking before you talk.
Huh? What do you mean? All I'm saying is I'm just a little worried about you, okay?
Well, don't be. I can have ice cream whenever I want.
You say that, But you know what's gonna happen if you keep eating ice cream all the time.
It's none of your business what I eat or how often!
Arguing over the consumption of a frozen dairy product. Ah, to be young.
Naive might be more accurate.
Kisara, let's talk for a bit.
Sorry for rambling on so much about my past earlier.
Don't sweat it. It was fun hearing you reminisce about the good old days.
Come on, you don't have to pretend with me. I know I can tend to go on sometimes when it comes to my brother.
You said it, not me. Anyway, I don't think it's something for you to be embarrassed about.
Hey, Alfin. When you were a kid, was there ever a time when you had to bury someone younger than you?
Well, it's hard to say. I'm guessing that you have, though.
Yeah. During the previous crown contest with the Lord before Dohalim, life back then was truly hell. I think that's why I tried to ignore what Migal was telling me for so long. Because I was afraid of going back to such a dark time, of losing hope. I wanted to believe in our paradise so much that I doubted the one person I should have trusted most. I don't blame blame Dohalim for that. I simply didn't want to face facts. And I ended up trying to project my ideals onto everyone else.
It's strange. Whenever you and Dohalim talk about Menencia, it's always like it's some big failure. We're talking about fixing 300 years worth of damage here. Isn't it a bit optimistic to think it was all going to be resolved after only 5?
You might be right. Maybe it was a mistake when Menencia... No. When I decided to stop seeing the darkness in our society. I have to admit the truth. To myself, first of all.
I'll take watch tonight. It's okay.
Rise and shine. We're almost ready to leave.
A dead end?
No, there's an elevator. Looks operational.
I can't believe there's actually an underground harbor here. There are even boats docked.
I only see Danites. Think they were forced to work here?
Probably. Let's see what they have to share about Almeidrea. You didn't happen to see a lord come by, did you?
Sorry, friend, but she just left. Came by with a whole posse of underlings, boarded her ship, and took off at first wind. We damn near got blown away. She was that much in a hurry.
Damn! So we missed her!
You guys trying to go after her? Need a ride?
Are you saying you know how to steer a ship?
Spent most of my life chained to the deck of some ship or other. Yeah, I know my jib from my boom.
We don't know how dangerous it'll be. Better you give us the boat and stay on solid ground.
Whoa there! You been out on the water before? The sea ain't nobody's friend, you know. You need a sea dog like me, or you'll sink her before she makes it out the harbor.
We're losing time. Sir, we're in your debt.
Now that's more like it. Name's Mahavar. Just give me a holler when you're all set and we'll set sail. This is like a dream come true. Never gotten to captain a ship before. Never would have thought I'd get a chance like this. Thank you, y'all.
The pleasure's all ours. Think we'll catch up to her?
Of course we will. They got too much weight on them. Meanwhile, this ship's carrying nothing but us salty scalawags. They got a good head start on us, but we can take them.
Do you know if there are any Danans on that ship?
Couldn't say for sure. On the one hand, seeing as it's supposed to be something of another castle, I'd reckon they probably wouldn't let a bunch of Danans on board. On the other hand, I'd be real surprised if the Renans were able to pilot that thing all by themselves. In any case, it's gonna be a while before we reach her. Until then, you're all free to do whatever. Just don't fall in the ocean.
I know Mahavar said we could take it easy, but there's not exactly a lot to do on this boat. I guess I'll check in on everyone and see how they're holding up.
I took a look around inside the ship just in case, but I didn't find anything that looked like it might be suspicious.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
You know, it wasn't until I left Calaglia that I finally realized just how big the world is.
When we tore down the wall in Calaglia, and I could finally see the horizon in the far-off distance, I had the exact same thought.
Yeah, somehow the sea is different, though. I'm not sure just how to put it. It's almost as if it just goes on forever. I bet my old man would have been blown away by this view.
Yeah.
Ever since he died, I've been thinking about what it was that he was really trying to say to me at the end. I keep going over his words again and again. And heck, maybe I'm just overthinking it all. But still, sometimes I wonder if it could have turned out differently. If there was something I could have done. But no matter how much I play it back, I'm still no closer to finding any answers. And then there's everything with Rinwell. I stopped her from killing Almeidrea, but was that really the right thing to do? Or did I just end up making things harder for her? I feel like such a screw-up.
You're not the only one. I keep asking myself what Zephyr would have done had he been here. Like, I think, how would Zephyr have handled Rinwell?
Yeah, I think he definitely would have stopped her. No doubt about it.
And that's exactly what you did, Law. I think he'd be really proud of you.
Alfin.
Zephyr's not the worst yardstick to measure ourselves against. Let's both do our best to make him proud.
Sounds like a deal. Thanks, Alfin.
Hold that pose long enough and someone might just come along and paint you.
Any artist who'd see fit to paint me needs their eyes tested.
What can you tell me about Almeidrea?
Not as much as you'd probably wish. I only ended up crossing paths with her a handful of times, after I was chosen to be a lord on Lenegas.
Ah, right. I almost forgot about Lenegas. How much do you think they know about what's been going on down here?
It's safe to assume they know everything, though I know not why they choose to remain uninvolved. Perhaps they see what's been happening as just part of the ongoing crown contest.
Even what Almeidrea did? Has it really reached the point where her actions are seen as normal?
Not to my knowledge, no. At its core, the Crown Contest is a competition to see who can amass the most astral energy. And to amass such energy, slaves are needed to collect it from. It's therefore against the Lord's interest to kill them.
So then why would Almeidrea do something like that?
We must remember that time is running out in the Crown Contest. Perhaps her hand was forced, so to speak. It is a way to accrue astral energy faster and in larger quantities than through slave labor. Doing so kills off that labor force, obviously. But it is a means to an end, nonetheless. No one could have foreseen that something like the Hollowing would arise back when the contest was first conceived.
Is becoming the Sovereign of Rena really that important to the Lords?
Of course. It's the greatest prize one can attain in their eyes. In that respect, at least, I'm really not that surprised that Almeidrea resorted to what she did, as utterly despicable as it is.
It's reassuring to hear you feel the same way I do.
I worry that the only reason I never did anything similar in Menencia was due to my lack of ambition.
If you didn't want to be reminded of your past, you could have just plugged your ears.
You think too highly of me. I'm afraid I must respectfully disagree. I'm not nearly as virtuous of a person as you might wish to believe.
If that's so, would you have been so shaken up when Kisara lost her brother? Why else would you turn your back on your own kind and choose to fight for Migal's dream? Aren't we just Danans?
A curious choice of words. Did what you see in Mahog Sar hit you that hard?
What Deadeim did to that city? He didn't liberate anyone. Anyone who refused to follow him was an enemy in his eyes. 300 years of Renan rule taught him nothing.
What I have come to understand is that the conflict extends beyond Danan versus Renan. There is an internal quarrel as well. I mean to bring about a true, lasting coexistence in Menencia. But there are more walls we must topple first.
And you don't think you can pull it off?
Well, you seem to think you can, at least.
Does that make us enemies?
Insofar as an exchange of swordplay, no, it doesn't.
Not good enough for you?
Are you really... Forgive me. I will continue to fight by your side a while longer. That much I have decided.
You don't look so good. You all right?
The floor. It keeps moving. How can you stand it? How can you even stand?
I'm not the best person to ask about discomfort. I can't feel pain, remember?
I still can't believe what happened in Niez. Even now. As a lord, my expectations for Almeidrea were already pretty low. But the way she treated human lives like they're mere playthings...
Yeah. And it wasn't as if the situation in Niez was improving much to begin with.
You mean Deadeim?
The whole reason I started fighting back was because of my anger at the atrocities of Renan rule. Back then, all I had to worry about was fighting the Renans for the sake of the Danans. But then I met Xion and the people of Menencia, and things became a lot more complicated. It's even messier now that we have to worry about Danans like Deadeim.
It used to be that the Danans were the ones in the right, and the Renans were the ones in the wrong. Though, maybe that was just a biased perspective, from being on the side of the oppressed.
Exactly. I'll never tolerate the Renans ruling over us. But nothing ever ends up being as black and white as you'd expect it to be either. That's clear to me now.
That said, even putting aside bad apples like Deadeim for a moment, you may be able to free the Danan people, but that won't undo 300 years of oppression. It'll be hard for them to not give in to their resentment. I think maybe that's why I clung to our dream so hard back in Menencia.
Even if his motivations weren't pure, Doalim has a good heart. He didn't sink to the depths Almeidrea did.
You don't understand. I'm saying that it goes deeper than that. This hierarchy we live in? It's not solely something the Renans invented. I remember a story Rinwell once told me. She said before the Renans invaded, we Danans had our own class system. We are the ones who divided ourselves. I saw it in Deadeim's eyes. He wanted to rule over others.
To hear Bayfon tell it, Deadeim wasn't always that way.
But as time went on, and he and the Darkwings fought the Renans. He eventually changed. I guess what I'm getting at is, if we defeat the Renans but just go back to the way things were before, was there even any point in fighting?
But that world isn't the one you want to create, right?
Maybe not. But to tell you the truth, these days I'm not so sure that dream is even possible.
You have your promise to Megal, though. Your home and the people of Menencia are depending on you.
I know. My brother. He truly believed in his dream of coexistence. And I suppose, even now, many people still do. And then, there's you.
Who, me?
You and Shion.
Not sure I follow.
Okay, then let me spell it out for you. How many other Renans and Danans do you know that get on as spectacularly as the two of you?
I don't know that I'd say spectacularly.
Well, I suppose it's really all a matter of how you look at it, isn't it?
I really don't see what you're getting.
I think I'm getting seasick again. Sorry. Can you just give me a wide berth for a few minutes?
Think Law is okay?
If you're worried, why don't you ask him yourself?
Yeah, I think maybe I should apologize to him too. I should apologize to all of you, really.
Us too?
Well, I was kind of lying to you all this whole time. I was blind to everything except my own revenge. I never even considered the struggles all of you might be facing.
We all have things we'd prefer to keep to ourselves, Rinwell. So what if you had something to hide? It doesn't undo the good that you've done, or the people that you've helped save along the way.
But that's not what I mean.
I know. You're talking about Almeidrea, right?
Yeah. I hate her, Alfin. I can't stop hating her. Even just thinking about her makes my head feel like it's going to explode. But it's not just her. I think about the way Law looked at me. I hated the Lord who killed my parents. And I hated the Renans I had to travel alongside. And yet, Cislodia's Danans backstab each other like it's a normal way of life. And Mahag Sar has people like Deadeye. But then there are people like Law and Shion. It's all just too much. I don't know what to think anymore.
Law never said that you had to forgive Almeidrea. It's only natural you would hate your family's murderer. But...
But what?
Law left home because of how much he hated his father. As a result of that, well, I think Law spent a lot of time thinking about how they never got to make things right. And if I had to guess, killing Ganabel didn't make any of those feelings go away. Law let revenge fuel him, and I think now he's afraid you'll do something you'll regret.
Afraid?
Whatever happens to Almeidrea when this is all over is up to you. I'll respect whatever choice you make. Just think it over carefully for me, okay? You still have time.
Okay. Thanks, Alfin. Say, back then, after the fight, I think I really made Shion mad. I don't know, though. Maybe it just looked that way. But I guess I just can't seem to understand how she feels. Do you know why she gets like that?
Shion's... She can be a tough nut to crack. She doesn't really talk a whole lot about herself.
It's just what she said about hate being a source of strength. Where did that come from? I wonder how it feels. Not being able to hold another person's hand.
Much further, you'll go overboard. Keeping an eye out for Almeidrea's ship?
I'm looking at the ocean.
The ocean?
Yeah. The waves. They help me think. This world is filled with natural wonders. The icy air and white peaks of Cislodia, the lush green glades of Menencia, the harsh wastes of Calaglia. But Menencia has its Lake of Death, and Nias its ruins. And they wouldn't be there if it weren't for that contest.
Say we actually manage to put a stop to the crown contest for good. What do you think will happen between the Danans and the Renans then?
You first.
Well, I want to believe that the coexistence we saw in Menencia can happen elsewhere too. It's just, it's insane for all of us to keep fighting. If Menencia can do it, so can everyone else.
Yeah, I think that would be good too. A world where everyone can get along. At least, that's what I've come to believe.
You sure have changed.
I can't lie to you. Since I was young, I've looked down on the Danans too. But I've seen a lot. And I see things differently now. I've seen so many ugly and terrible things in this world. And yet, they didn't come from just the Danans. And the good things, too. They didn't come from just the Renans. Kindness and cruelty exist on both sides. A person's race doesn't factor into it. So, I guess you're right after all, Alfin. I have changed. You know, I've never actually touched another person like this.
Shion.
Ever since I was on Lenegas, I've always been alone. Even after I came to Danna. Always.
And now?
Do you still not remember your past?
No. Sometimes it feels like I can almost remember. But then this mask stops me.
The mask keeps you from remembering why you have the mask in the first place. It's a little ironic, isn't it?
A little. Well, it won't be long now before you're rid of those thorns, you know? Only two lords remain. And once you have their master course, you'll be able to create the Renis Alma, right? Then you can... Shion?
Sorry, it's nothing. Promise. You're right, though. It'll all be over soon. I never could have made it this far on my own. I have everyone to thank for that. Including... especially you, Alphen.
Don't worry about it. We're friends, after all.
Yeah, we are.
Wonder how much longer it's going to be before we catch up to Almeidrea. I'll ask Mahavar.
Look who's up! Good timing. We're closing in on her stern as we speak.
That's the ship? She's huge. Law, go gather the others, will you? Think you'll be able to flank them without getting spotted?
Yeah, with the fog as our ally, I think I might just pull it off. Long as we ain't too noisy, we should be okay.
What'll you do if they catch on to us?
Not much I can do. Ship that size, they'll probably blow us to bits before we ready cannons.
Persistent little things. Evidently, I shouldn't have spared the wretched vermin. Hungry already, my dear? Worry not. For you shall have plenty to feast upon shortly.
Perfect. You managed to get us right up beside them.
I'll stay with the ship so we can leave as soon as you're done.
Good. Then let's find Almeidrea.
Xion, I want to thank you.
What brought this on?
What you said helped to calm me.
Don't mention it.
Now that's what I call a ship!
Yeah. The biggest one in all of Mahogsar. So big that it took years to construct.
For all we know, Kel'Zelik may well have been smuggling materials to help build it. In which case it would be yet another mistake on my part.
We don't know that she was only getting materials from Menencia.
You think it's possible that they might have come from elsewhere, too? Yeah, I guess I could see it.
But what do you think Almeidrea plans to do from here on out, now that she's abandoned her realm and sailed out to sea?
She'll be filling her coffers with gold, most likely. Then she'll sit back and enjoy the show as the other lords duke it out. Or something to that effect, at least.
I wouldn't put it past her.
She's strong, yet shrewd. And will stoop to any low. A dangerous one indeed.
She's not the first, and she won't be the last. This is a lord we're talking about, remember?
Sounds like you've made up your mind already.
There was never anything to decide. No one who can smile like that while doing what she did deserves to roam free.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
This might not be the best time, but if you have a minute.
Hmm?
That mask of yours, it was shattered by a blow from Balseth when you fought back in Calaglia, correct?
Yeah, thanks for the reminder. I thought I was a goner.
Balseth's brute strength was in a league all its own, yet half the mask remains. It's remarkably durable. Too durable to be Danon in origin.
Xion said the same thing. As if the fact I was wearing it meant there had to be more to me than met the eye.
You recalled your name when the mask broke, I hear.
Yeah, that's right. Although to tell you the truth, I'm a little scared what might happen when I lose the remaining half. Then again, the idea of not doing something because I'm afraid scares me even more. That's why I go on fighting.
Only he who first faces the night catches a glimpse of the dawn.
Come again?
It's nothing. Forget I said anything.
Comfortable win.
Well,
are you okay? You're not too tired, are you?
Nope, I'm fine. Let's keep moving. Hi, Hoodle.
Eat this. You're mine.
Dragon
Sword.
I'm ready.
We did it. Now, here I come. It's over.
Resonate with the earth.
Stalagmite.
The Dragon Sword.
Here!
Thunder Shield! You seem to me.
Yeah!
I'm ready!
Me!
Any injuries?
if you know what's good for you.
Engaging!
I'll smash you!
You're finished!
I'll have to take my revenge on you!
Where are you going?
Here I come! Dragon Swarm!
Fall back!
Be still!
Glacial Spear! Pierce Evil!
Water on energy!
Glacial Spear!
Pierce Evil!
Thunder Blade! Freeze Lancer!
No further!
Take it off!
Commander of Heaven!
Phoenix Cyclone!
I'm ready!
Astral Energy!
Say no more!
Our work is done here. Let's move.
I'm right behind you, Shion.
I won't forgive you!
Pieces!
I'm only getting started! Not on my watch!
Whoa!
You think that shield will save you?
War with that cannon!
We're not finished!
Here's the evil! Do it! This ends now!
Consider yourself finished!
Ha ha! Am I on a roll or what?
Well, look who's in a bright and shiny mood.
You've got spirit!
This one's mine!
Is it too late to talk over our differences?
Astral energy!
Say no more!
Shattering the pieces! Attack time!
Annihilation!
On your
new escape! Dragon Swarm!
Air pressure!
I'm ready!
This ends now!
Consider yourself finished!
Small, but a victory nonetheless.
We have a long way yet to go.
To me.
Done.
never seen anything like it.
It's an authentication key. They're quite common.
Maybe where you're from, but this is new to me.
It might go in an elevator somewhere. We should test it out.
Nice. No scratches on my shield or my armor.
Necessary when creating weaponry.
Looks like some solid equipment.
Glacial
Steel!
Mirage!
Tempest!
Glacial
Steel!
Armor!
Razor!
Your mind!
Glacial
Eagle!
believe it's safe to assume these were used in her experiments.
They certainly look as twisted as her.
Even here.
That food there looks pretty tasty.
Yep, we can fix that new recipe with it.
I eagerly await the final result.
Just like this back in Estaluba Forest.
It looks and smells like some kind of medicine.
Whatever this place was used for, I doubt it was anything of repute.
Don't get careless.
A barrier. That may indicate Almeidrea is near.
Then we've got to find a way to get through somehow.
Let's see if we can find something that'll release it.
What is that huge flower-looking thing up there? Is that the ship's engine?
Indubitably. As one might expect, large ships require large engines in order to sail.
And if we destroyed it?
We might well sink the ship. Who knows if we would be able to escape before that happens.
Almeidrea sure has been busy since the contest began.
This isn't Almeidrea's doing.
You mean she didn't build this?
The body, yes. However, my guess is that the engine comes from a starship.
A starship? As in one of those vessels used to go to and from Lenegas?
Correct. The technology employed on Lenegas and in starships is more advanced than anything in our daily lives. Almeidrea may be resourceful, but she could never produce an engine like this on her own.
You mean to tell me we've got even bigger enemies waiting for us up in the sky? Ugh, my head hurts just thinking about it.
Don't worry about that for now. Just focus on taking care of Almeidrea. What's this thing?
No choice! Bring him down!
Can't get out of this!
Anything in armor is all mine!
Resonate with the armor!
I can carve through armor!
Tell me, have you ever considered your...
Do it! This ends now!
Consider yourself finished!
Barely a blip on our radar. Get lost!
Here I come!
Now you'll learn!
Let us suck in to the wind!
You're mine!
Dragon Floor! Rending you apart!
Bloody howling!
Where are you going?
Take it!
More with the
Sulfur!
Take it!
Dragon Floor!
Look sharp!
Lightning Tiger Blade!
Not a chance!
Too fast!
Stand back! I'll trip it up!
You're mine!
Bolt
blood!
Rending you up!
Dragon Swarm!
Bloody Howling!
I'm ready!
Show me! In an instant!
Impact Block!
Small, but a victory nonetheless.
We have a long way yet to go. Who's in a bright and shiny mood?
You're saying we should check the owl forest?
Lightning Tiger Blade!
Our work is done here. Let's move.
I'm right behind you, Shion.
Gotta break through!
You've got spirit!
Take this! Not today!
Move at the marksman!
Like we won.
An opponent like this should be easy.
I'll smash you!
Glacial spear.
Denied!
Hydration
freeze
lens! Here I come!
Glacial spear.
Down on the
ground.
Dragon Swarm!
Freeze Lancer! Not in your dreams! Radiant Pierce!
Take it! I'm not done!
Heal for it!
Air Pressure! Dragon Swarm!
Radiant Slap here!
Rending you apart!
Dazzle! Here I come!
Do it!
Kisara!
Commander of Heaven!
Phoenix Cyclone!
Land in the wind!
Take it!
Radiant Slap!
I'm practically unstoppable.
Like this should be easy.
Engage it!
You picked the wrong fight! Captain! Dragon Force!
Fire support!
Now!
Grimmer!
Astral energy!
Say no more! Now!
Here I come!
I'm not done!
I'm ready!
Look sharp!
Lightning Tiger Blade!
My exploits are bearing fruit. Thus our strength yet grows.
Thank you.
him down.
It's over.
Take this. Dragon swarm.
Cosmic rupture.
She sure spared no expense on her castle.
This must be...
the captain's quarters. The presence of the spirit vessel and the sheer extravagance on display can leave no doubt.
There's no one here.
Yeah, but I doubt she's out for a moonlight stroll. You think she jumped ship and ran away again?
I doubt it. The conniving witch is probably up to something.
Agreed. In any case, as long as she hasn't suddenly sprouted wings, she has to be somewhere on the ship. Let's keep looking. The way this key's been placed, it's like she's daring us to come find her.
Yeah, like it's all some damn game to her.
What's wrong, sweetie? Is something scaring you?
Maybe he just doesn't like being in her room.
I think there's more to it than that. What could it be? Thank you.
this the ship's cargo? What a pain. I can't see anything past all this stuff.
Be on your guard. For all we know, there could be something hiding around here. What's this thing?
Like we got them all.
Don't get careless.
That equip... ...ment should come in handy.
Here's
the
evil!
Resonate with the earth!
Hands
on your knees!
Here I come!
Let's go!
Extra energy!
Eat
This should make for some good weapon crafting material. Did that get rid of the barrier?
We'll just have to go back and check.
If Almeidrea is not in her own room, just where the hell is she?
It's possible she may be on the bridge, but I would guess that she's waiting for us elsewhere on the ship.
Which means she's most likely chosen a place where she'll have the advantage in a fight.
Be careful, guys. I came from an entire family of Danon mages, and that woman murdered all of them. All on her own. I hate to say it, but she's an incredibly powerful astral artist.
We already know she specializes in controlling wind astral energy. But on top of that, she might try to sick that monster on us again, too.
Right. To that woman, life itself is just a toy for her to play with. Let's make sure we put an end to it. Place to look. Straight ahead.
Almeidrea.
There she is! Almeidrea!
But all alone? Watch yourselves. She's probably planning something.
I was getting rather tired of waiting around. Oh my, and I see you came along as well, Danon Witch.
Almeidrea.
What's this? I thought you couldn't stand the sight of me. Go on, little one. Show me the full force of that hatred of yours. Otherwise, run and hide like the rat you are.
That's enough! How can you smile while causing pain to so many others?
That is the way of those who possess great power. The very way we run. Those with power set the example, and those without it are forced to obey. Though you two seem to have forgotten that's the way these things work.
And you really think that justifies your actions? You turned all those people into a hollowed sea!
What foolishness. It's only natural that the fate of a slave differ from that of its owner. Very well, I admit I did fan the flames just a tad back in the end. But it wouldn't have mattered in the slightest if there hadn't been a spark to ignite. Without it, my actions would have been fruitless. Ultimately, it was their very own burning hatred that laid them to waste. To say it was all my fault is simply laying blame at the wrong feet.
No one's perfect. We all have darkness in our hearts. But the atrocities that you've committed, they're unthinkable! Your heart! Is nothing but darkness!
What a fool! To think time and time again you would challenge Renan authority without so much as an inkling of how things actually work. Such ignorance is why your kind has been enslaved for 300 years.
Almeidrea.
Well, if it isn't Lord Dohalim.
These people are my allies and friends. I won't let you insult them so.
My, what a shock. I never would have expected you to claim mere slaves as your companions. If I didn't know any better, I would question your noble lineage. Oh, how far the mighty have fallen. A traitor such as yourself hardly deserves to be called a lord.
You are nothing compared to Dohalim.
Rinwell.
He would never stand by and laugh. His people hollowed!
Ha! What does it matter? You're descended from those who allowed the power and knowledge entrusted to them to wither away. Your pitiful family may have feared it, but I do not. that knowledge and power is all mine to command. And now, you will witness what that power's truly capable of. Mesmold!
Sad eyes, child. Let me reunite you with your parents.
Shut up! I'm gonna take you down if it's the very last thing I do!
That's right. Loathe me. Every step brings you closer to being me!
You're wrong! You're wrong! I'm nothing like you!
Take this!
Dance in the wind!
I never miss!
Run! Air drop!
It's your turn!
You're mine!
Armor won't save you!
Down on the ground!
My astral
oh my!
Lunar
you're mine! Dance to the wind!
Lunar Blast!
You're not done!
Your place.
And I'm done!
Let's have
some fun!
Not on my watch!
Catch-up!
Shining
not today!
Healing Circle!
I get
Radiant
Blast! Here I come!
Right.
Radiant
Blast! Celestial
on your
water! Stay your way! What's she doing now?
She's infusing her beast with more power.
Get ready!
No further!
Deal force!
Where are you going?
They smite the
dragon blade! Now, ready to go! We got the energy! First aid!
Execution!
A clean sword of permission!
Not today!
You're brimming with hatred!
Here! Here! Hard malevolence!
Armor won't waterfall. Save you!
Seal! I'll be saving you! The waters of creation magic is there!
Here's a healing arc!
First aid! Not in your dream!
Damn you!
Down on the ground!
Come on!
Not in your dream!
Get out of this!
Raging Storm!
I'll face you!
Celestial Hammer!
Death from the wind!
Doomfall!
Shattering of pieces! Attack time!
Steel! I never fit! Pierce the evil!
Take it away!
Soaring
Blast! Raging Storm!
You picked the wrong fight!
Raging Storm!
By the power of...
mind!
She's no stranger to astral arts.
I can take care of that.
Yeah, take it away. I'll smash you!
Far enough!
You will suffer!
Water, right. Hear my call! Spread! Behold my true power!
Can't get out of this!
That looks bad.
Wits about you, people!
Hey,
you're mine!
I'm on top now!
The winds of judgment blow your way!
Impending calamity! Chaotic disaster!
So that's the trick of her sleeve.
Your astral arts aren't so special. And now, they're mine!
You'll pay for that! Dragon's
Roar!
Raging
Cascade!
Go
fast!
You murdered my mother and father. But I'm not like you.
Renwell.
Even now, I hate you. But here I am, unable to let go. Honestly, even if I took my hatred out on you here and now, it wouldn't make me feel any better in the long run. I realize that now. So, I won't kill you. I'll take you in, and make damn sure justice is served the right way.
You would dare mock me with your foolish, useless pity? A Danon, nothing more than a mere slave. I won't allow you to...
It's not about what you think. Or being Danon or Renan. Because you'll atone for the crimes you committed. And that's all.
That swordsman again.
Oh, Lord Volron, what brings you here? No, forgive me. I've forgotten myself. Please allow me to make it up to you, my lord.
Silence now, wretched snake. Does it hurt? It should. That pain is proof you're still alive. Enjoy it.
Years ago, the Lord of Geneth Haros met a sudden death. His successor was a man by that very name, Volron.
And like a restless lover, I've come back for more.
Alvin!
and find me. If you truly are the Sovereign. After all this time, I'll be free from this hell. I can finally go home. I doubt I'll ever see this place again. Might as well walk the block once more for old time's sake. As usual, nobody wants to explain anything to me. They just threaten and harass me instead. What does everyone think I am? Some sort of talking pet? They're the ones that dragged me all the way up here in the first place. Bastards. I shouldn't have bothered coming out. Might as well head back to my room. I just wanted to go back to Dana, to my home.
Alfin.
Naori. Wait, please. Wait, I... I... What was that? That... How long ago was that? That's right. Shion. Everyone. I need to find them. Better start looking. she on? I...
Without this pain. Rinwell.
What happened just now? Normally you'd be able to take that thing with your eyes closed.
Thank goodness you're alive. Are you all right?
Yeah.
I'm just glad we found you in one piece. You were the only one still missing. There's a village back the way we came from, Thistleim. Kisara and Law are already there.
Rinwell, where are we?
Ganeth Haros, Volron's realm, remember?
Ushered by the waves straight to the enemy stronghold. A rare stroke of luck, it would seem.
Luck?
If Volron's here, that means Xion's close too, right?
Xion? Oh. Right. Of course.
Are you sure you're feeling okay? You seem a little... off.
He's probably just exhausted. Let's save the catching up for when we're back at the village.
Sense one of your pals, Hoodle?
In a bind?
Here I go!
With astral energy!
Shine! Radiant light! Force of regeneration! Regenerate!
Lightning orb!
Thanks!
Lightning condemned!
Here I come!
Thunder blade! Illumination dark!
Soaring drop!
Holy quiver! Holy
dragon swarm! Lightning thrust!
Illumination! Shine! Radiant light! Force of regeneration! Regenerate!
I owe you one! Raging cascade!
Thanks! Try harder!
My turn! Resonate with the earth!
Dragon form!
Stalagmite!
In here!
Based in
this one's all mine!
Eat dirt!
Bloody hell!
Astral arts?
That's my
Resonate
deal!
Resonate with the earth!
Shut him down!
Dragon form!
Arc shield!
No escape! Dragon form!
Scream based in blood! Rending you apart!
Dragon
Bloody
form!
Howling.
Now!
Jolly!
In an instant!
Impact block! My turn! No escape!
Lightning orb!
You're mine!
More where that came from!
Dragon swarm!
Dance in the wind! Air thrust!
I'm ready!
Jolly!
In an instant!
Impact block!
Quite necessary when creating weaponry.
Speaking of Thistleim, it's populated by Danans, but they're not under the rule of any lord. Pretty refreshing, huh? The whole town was built by Danan defectors, escapees from elsewhere. This area's teeming with stray Zoogles, though, so heaven only knows how they managed to set up a community here. The ordeal seems to have left them understandably on edge. Kisara and La are back there right now, trying to convince them of our good intentions. Say, Alfin, it looks like you got your face back then.
Yeah. And your sense of pain, too, it would seem. Any connection?
Really? Oh, but that means...
Probably.
I wonder if Alfin's going to be okay.
For now, I believe we should hold off on speculation and simply keep an eye on him.
Right. You're saying we should check the Owl Forest? Do you sense one of your friends, Hoodle?
Alfin! Boy, am I glad to see you safe!
Well, did you manage to convince them we're not in league with any lord?
Yeah, eventually.
When the ship sank, I thought we were done for. Guess the world just couldn't keep us apart.
Yeah, and now we can finally go rescue Xion.
There's something I need to tell you guys first. I got my memory back.
So, what did you remember? Are you able to tell us now?
Give the man some space, Law.
I remember being up on Lenegas. Go on. I was abducted from Dana. I was told if I ever wanted to return home, I'd have to cooperate. So that's what I did. Next thing I knew, they had made me into the Sovereign.
You mean to say you won the crown contest? As a Danon?
No. They kept me locked in a strange facility. They experimented on me, like I was nothing more than an animal. There were others, but only I survived. Of course, I wasn't really a king. The reality was that they treated me worse even than the lowest slave. The only reason I survived was because my body was able to withstand the Sovereign's power that they placed inside me.
The crest that appeared behind you on Almeidrea's ship must have undoubtedly been that of the Sovereign. It all makes sense now. Your affinity with the Blazing Sword, the strange powers you possess, they were all because you were the Sovereign.
Okay, but why would the Renans go out of their way to give you all that power? Just what exactly does being the Sovereign entail?
They said it was for something called the Spirit Channeling Ceremony. They taught me how to harness my power for when the big day came. As for what the ceremony was actually for, unfortunately, I never found out.
So if what you're saying about being on Lenegas is true, then maybe you really did meet Xion. After all, you said you recognized her from somewhere, right?
But Xion said she'd never seen him before. How do you explain that?
I was wrong. It wasn't Xion I knew from Lenegas. It was Nayori. She was a Renan maiden they paired me with during the spirit channeling ceremony. She's the woman I kept seeing in my dreams.
A maiden? What? Wait, so this Nayori figure just happens to be the double of Xion? Bit coincidental, isn't it?
Naori's family name was Imeris.
Imeris? As in Xion Imeris?
So they're distant relatives or something? Wait, or are they sisters?
Your guess is as good as mine. All I know is it was Naori. She's the one who put the mask on me.
The mask? But why?
To keep my soul from devouring itself over the guilt. After what I did on Lenegas. Over the lives I took.
Lives? You mean you staged a rebellion? Perhaps it was a part of this spirit channeling ceremony?
I don't know. Whatever it was that the spirit channeling ceremony was supposed to achieve, it didn't turn out as planned. I lost consciousness halfway through. By the time I came to, Lenegus was a sea of flames. I opened my eyes to see Naori there, weeping. I shudder to think of how many deaths I caused that day. Certainly more than any of these lords can claim, I'm sure.
You really expect us to believe this? First the Sovereign, then Lenegus? You couldn't possibly have done all that.
I wonder. In ancient scripture, there is tell of a terrible calamity that befell Lenegus, nearly destroying it. The restoration took years, and required the work of countless laborers.
By ancient, you mean...
It predates the Crown Contest, to a time before even the first Renan invasion of Dana. More than 300 years ago.
300? But that'd make Alfin...
That's right. I'm pretty much an antique of a human being. Deep down, maybe I already knew.
Alfin!
Some hero, huh? Cooperating with the same villains who snatched me from my home, committing mass slaughter, only for it to slip my mind. Then, when I finally remember, turns out I'm so old, I've got scripture written about me. So much for standing up to injustice. I've probably got more blood on my hands than all the lords combined!
Alfin, stop!
Honestly, I'm not going to pretend to understand what all this means. But what I do know is that right now, you're just reacting to the shock. Listen, what you really need is time. Time to process things and get your head straight. Truth be told, I think that probably goes for all of us.
What about Shion? We can't just...
I'm worried about Shion too, Law. But it's clear that Alfin's in no fit state to fight. This is Volron, remember? Even at full capacity, it's practically a suicide mission. We stay put in the village till we're ready. Okay, everyone? Take some time to think things through, okay? But remember, we're all here for you if you need us. No matter how dark things might seem, you're not alone, Alfin.
Thank you.
It's fine. All right, everyone. Let's break for now.
Do I even have the right to fight? Do I have the right to go to Shion's rescue? What do the others think?